My name is Tony Kushner. I'm a playwright, and we are at the midway point of our second week of rehearsals of my play, The Intelligent Homosexual's Guide to Capitalism and Socialism with the Key to the Scriptures. It's great to be back in the Bay Area, and it's really wonderful to be at this theater. Outside of New York City, it's the only theater in the United States where I feel completely at home. Tony and I have worked together for almost 37, 38 years, and we've developed a really extraordinary collaboration. We've done a lot of stuff together. We've been through a lot of stuff together. We're very close friends. It's great. It's also great to have some time off, which I've now had a couple of years away from IHO, and which is what we call the play for short, IHO, because the title is just unbearably, unforgivably long. The play was written for the Guthrie Theater for a production in 2009, and then it was done in New York in a co-production between the Public and the Signature Theaters in 2010. I came here with a list of things that I'd already changed. And I've, in the last week and a half, I've developed a new list and checked items off of a new list of mostly small things. A couple of what I consider to be fairly substantial changes. It's a big play, and it tackles things that I find very challenging to really think about and to look at, which is sort of what I think is my job as a writer. It's set in 2007 in an Italian-American part of Brooklyn, near the Brooklyn waterfront, and it's a fictional branch of a family that actually exists, one of the members of which was a congressman from the 1930s to the 1950s, Vito Marcantonio, and he was a radical, possibly a communist. And this is a made-up branch of the Marcantonio family. The patriarch in this family, Gus Marcantonio, is a younger cousin of the congressman. In the summer of 2007, Gus Marcantonio, who's a retired longshoreman, has decided to commit suicide at the age of 72. And he had attempted suicide the year before. And he has three grown children, and they are sort of summoned to the house to hear that he wants to kill himself and why. Each of these people has a very complicated personal life, and the personal lives sort of come into the brownstone along with the kids. This is a play where people with a lot of characters who are very, very political characters, and they talk about politics, labor politics, Marxism, socialism. They talk about these things a lot, but there's also a great deal going on with them that's, you don't have to be a Marxist to understand. I hope the audience will recognize in this family's struggle things that speak to their own lives and struggles and their communities and also their families. Just come see the play. It's really good stuff at Berkeley Rep, so come see the play.